one more song to you, and this song is called Tired. It's not about physical tiredness, I keep in shape.
What shape?
This shape. Oh, it is a shape, you know. But it's not about that really, it's about passing a flag. Most of my adult life I've held certain beliefs, political and social, and I've never been shy going in the streets and supporting them and waving banners and singing We Shall Overcome and all that sort of stuff. My very first protest march, I like to call them social awareness marches, was in Scotland in 1960. I was 16 years old. I was a member of the CND, Campaign for a Nuclear Disarmament. Looks like we might have to make about a comeback. But it was the Americans put Polaris submarines, nuclear armed submarines, in the Holy Loch in Scotland. There you go, Holy Loch. And it made Scotland at that time the number one target for Russian missiles. But about 4 minutes, 26 seconds to finish off a bottle of whiskey. No problem. The first march I went on was a protest march in Dunoon, where the Americans had their big naval supply depot there. So we went and blockaded the gates and all that sort of stuff and tried to stop these big trucks coming to renew the Americans. And the trucks were driven by big black guys, you know, enormous fellas, as we Scotsmen, you know. And they were great, and they loved it all. They were throwing candy at us through the window and saying, "We hate this shit too, man." It's so good humour, you know. And we went to what a big rally in George Square in Glasgow, with 20,000 people. And I heard my first folk music there, and I was standing, you know, feeling a wee bit like a wee boy from a country town in Peebles, which I was, and feeling a bit, you know, self-conscious, and they started singing We Shall Overcome. 20,000 people started singing. And I felt the hairs above my head go, and I've loved folk music ever since. It just spoke to me, you know, spoke to my heart, spoke to my conscience, spoke to everything. And that was it. That was a love affair that's lasted. And every time I hear that song still, you know, even though it's become a sort of cliche, I suppose, I still feel, I think, oh boy, I remember that. When I was young and full of piss and vinegar. The last match I was on was Iraq War number one, where John Howard sent our boys and girls into harm's way without asking anybody, including the United Nations. So we had a protest march in Adelaide. 100,000 Adelaideans turned up. 100,000, you couldn't believe it. You have to know Adelaideans to know what a surprise that is. Very comfortable people, Adelaideans. Yeah. And I don't know if you know, a lot of you won't know the geography, but we gathered in Victoria Square and marched along King William Street to the Parliament House. But what, 3/4 mile, if that? So we were standing in Victoria Square, you know, waiting for the march to start, and it seemed to take a while, you know. And then I saw this steward with a steward's badge passing. I said, "Hey, mate, when's the march going to start?" He said, "It's finished." "What do you mean it's finished?" There were so many people there, it was so long that the head of the had reached Parliament House half an hour before. And they thought, "Oh, that's the march finished." "Oh, pissed off and went home." You know. That was the last one. It was the best march I was ever on. You reach a stage in your life, no matter how committed you are to various causes, where you just get past it. Everybody gets past it eventually. And if you're too crooked to go, you're too old, you've got arthritis. Australia's got talents on the television. There's so many reasons why you can't go. So you look around for somebody younger and stronger to pass the flag to and say, "Right, it's your job now. I've done it for 60 years, your body will do it." And that's how it should happen. I've said you should be more polite about it, of course. So I wrote a song about that. It's called Tired.
2, 3, 4.
sucking in my breath, and just let my stomach sag. Let young strong hands pick up the bag. I got the butter around my garden and tend my roses, spread compost around and watch as it decomposes. Spend 3 nights a week playing pokies down at the pub, and apply to join the Albany Bowling Club. I'm tired of singing We Shall Overcome. I'm tired of always marching to a distant different drum, tired of knocking my poor head against brick walls and trying to catch the flag every time it falls. I'm gonna walk my dogs every day for a few hours. When we stop to do their business, I'll stop and smell the flowers. And we long saw boots about dragons, orcs and elves, and this world and all its troubles can always go away. Some get up and go, young and strong.